Hey brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick in the Philippines making my second video, trying to stay on target here. As I started in the beginning of the other video, you know, the breaking news, Colossians chapter 2 verse 15, talking about Jesus on the cross, nailing it to the cross, and having spoiled principalities and powers, he had made a show of them, openly triumphing over them in it. We got the victory in Christ Jesus. The enemy's already been defeated on the cross. He's already been defeated on the cross. Listen to me. Let's see. Verse 8. Colossians chapter 2, verse 8. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit, after the traditions of men, after the rudiments of the world, and not after Christ. For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily, and ye are complete in him. You're complete in Christ. We don't need anything else. I can live and be a Christian and go to heaven without anything. I don't need to hear, know anything about the types and shadows from the Old Testament. I know those things because I'm a preacher, and God put it in my heart to be interested in those things, to teach what? Christ. The Bible says the spirit of prophecy is Jesus Christ. All roads in the Bible lead to Jesus Christ. All roads lead to the fact that we need redemption through Jesus Christ. The Bible says the law is a schoolmaster that brings us to the knowledge of sin and death. The only thing I learned from the law is no man can keep it. Even as Peter said, even as James, the half-brother of Jesus Christ, said in Acts chapter 15, none of us can keep it. Why are we trying to put something on the Gentiles that we ourselves cannot keep? And Paul also rebuked, for all you Roman Catholics, Paul rebuked Peter, who, by the way, in the same text in Galatians, it says Peter was appointed to the Jews, Paul to the Gentiles. Paul is a much more candidate to latch on to as a first pope, even though there is no first pope. Anyway, brothers and sisters, verse 9, Colossians chapter 2, verse 9. We already read that. For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily. And you are complete in him, verse 10, which is the head of all principality and power. Jesus is the head of all power and principality. We got the victory through Christ Jesus. That's what I'm talking to you about. We got the victory over all the power of the enemy, and we got the victory over the law. Because what the law could not do was done in Christ. In whom also ye are circumcised with a circumcision made without hands. You know, I talk about this text all the time, but I never read it. I quote out of this text all the time in all my videos with the Judaizers. With a circumcision made without hands, in putting off the body of sins of the flesh by the circumcision of Christ, that's of the heart, buried with him in baptism, wherein also ye are risen with him through the faith of the operation of God, who hath raised him from the dead. And ye being dead in your sins, and uncircumcised of your flesh, hath he quickened, that means given life, together with him, having forgiven you all trespasses, blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that were against us, which was contrary to us, and took it out of the way, nailing it to his cross, and having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it. Jesus triumphed over death, hell, and the grave, the world, the flesh, and the devil, when he defeated Satan at the cross and all the power of evil. Verse 16, Colossians chapter 2, let no man therefore judge you. Listen to me, all you Judaizers. I already made a video back every year at Christmas and Easter. Let no man therefore judge you in meat or in drink, or in the respect of any holy day, or in the new of the new moon, or of the Sabbath days. Don't let nobody judge you. You know there's people. I don't know why. It's because they never read the Bible. They're on there. I don't know what to do. I don't want to sin. I don't know whether to celebrate Christmas. Sit down and be quiet and read the Bible. Read the New Testament. Stop trying to read the law and the prophets and all this and getting all confused. Next thing you know, you're wearing a yarmulke and a prayer shawl. And as I mentioned before, you're a woman walking around with a prayer shawl on, which you're not supposed to wear a prayer shawl if you're a woman. You're not supposed to wear one if you're a Gentile. Walking around trying to follow the law and babbling and mixing up all this different Old Testament, New Testament. That's the question. Are you before Christ or after Christ? Are you living in B.C. or A.D.? You know, are you Are you living in before Christ? I'm living in AD, the year of our Lord, the year of Jesus Christ, the year of our Lord, Anno Deum, the Lord Jesus Christ is who it's talking about, the year 2014. Since the birth of Christ, I'm living in AD, after Christ, not before Christ. Maybe you're living in before Christ. Maybe some of you are in the twilight zone. Maybe like the land of the lost, you know, you're down there with the slea stacks in the land of the lost. Well, I want to tell you, I think you do need to get in a pyramid and play with some crystals, and maybe you'll teleport yourself back to reality, back to 2014 AD, the year of our Lord, Anno Deum. That's where we are right now, the year of the Lord Jesus Christ. We're in the New Testament. We're under the covenant of grace and the blood of Christ for anyone who's a child of God. Jesus told those Pharisees, hey, you think that in the Old Testament you have eternal life? That stuff you're reading is not about eternal life. It's talking about me. Jesus said it's all talking about me. And then in John chapter 1, it says, to them who believe on him, the Lord Jesus Christ, to them he gave power to become the sons of God. You become a son of God through the blood of Christ, not by being an Israelite. That doesn't make you a son of God. To become, that's in the after the flesh. To become a child of God is through the blood of Christ only. Jesus said, those who do not believe on me are condemned already. Did he say Gentiles who do not believe on me? Or anyone who doesn't believe on me? What did he say? Whosoever believeth in him, the Messiah, shall have eternal life. Then he goes on to say, who does not believe is condemned already. Did he say that, is it qualified to the Gentiles? No, he was talking, as a matter of fact, he was talking to a Jewish audience. He was talking to Israelis, not to any Gentiles. He was talking to them, anyone. I don't care if you're a Jew, Gentile, bond, or Greek. When the Bible says when you become a Christian, it doesn't matter. There's no more Jew, no more male, female, no more bond or free. All are one in Christ, it says. By the way, God is not a man, and God is not a part of any tribe. God is not a Jew. God is above all that. That's his creation. God is immutable, which means God is unchanging. God was here before the creation he made was ever here. God was here as the Trinity from the very beginning, and God is immutable. He didn't become a Jew. He didn't become an Israelite. God came in the flesh through the natural seed of Abraham as a man on this earth in that nation of Israel. But God, even the Son of God, God came as the Son of Man. He walked this earth as an Israelite, as a Jewish person of the tribe of Judah. But God is not a Jew. That's just like people saying, the Roman Catholics saying that, you know, Mary is the mother of God. If God is God, by definition, he doesn't have a mother. She is the human earthly vessel that gave birth to the Messiah as the Son of Man. When Jesus came on this earth and manifested himself in the flesh as the Son of Man. But he was the Son of God, God the Son, in eternity from times past and forevermore in the future. He's outside of time. When he stepped down into time, he was born with a woman. Mary was not there in the beginning of before creation, the foundation of the world. Mary was not there in heaven with God beforehand. No. She was a creation, just like the rest of us, into the creation of the earth. Long before Abraham was born, as Jesus said himself, before Abraham was born, I am. Before Abraham was born, I am. Let's see. Let no man beguile you. Oh, so anyway, let no man therefore judge you in meat or in drink in respect of any holy day or of the new moons or any Sabbath days. Don't let nobody judge you if you do try to keep the Sabbath or don't keep the Sabbath. Don't let nobody judge you if you want to celebrate Christmas or not celebrate Christmas or New Year's or not New Year's. What part of this is written in the Bible don't you understand? Don't let no man judge you. We only have one judge, that's the Lord. Which are a shadow. Listen to this. This is what I quote this all the time to these Judaizers. Listen to me. Which are a shadow of things to come, but the body is of Christ. Let no man beguile you of your reward in a voluntary humility and worshiping of angels, intruding into those things which he had not seen, vainly puffed up in his fleshly mind, and not holding the head from which all the body by joints and hands, having nourished, ministered, and knit together, increase with the increase of God. Now the head is Christ. Wherefore, if you are dead with Christ from the rudiments of the world, why, as though living in the world, are you subject to ordinances? Touch not, taste not, handle not, which all are to perish with the using, after the commandments and doctrines of men, which things have indeed a show of wisdom and will worship and humility and neglecting of the body, not in any honor to the satisfying of the flesh. It's complicated King James English. You can go look it up in another translation if you can't understand it. Chapter 3, verse 1. If ye then, being risen with Christ, seek those things which are above. Seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affection on things above, not on things of the world. For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with him in glory. Listen to me. Listen to this. Set your things on above. Stop having your affections on trying to keep these Old Testament feast that John tells us are the feast of the Jews. John says Jesus went up to the feast of the Jews. He didn't say it's for the Gentiles and for the church. John wrote his way up there in 90 AD. The Gospel of John. He didn't say anything about the church needs to be involved in that. He didn't say the feast that we keep. No, the feast of the Jews. Feast of the Jews. Stop worrying and getting obsessed on things of this earth. These are a shadow, as we just read. It says, verse 17, Colossians chapter 2, verse 17, these things which are a shadow of things to come, but the body is of Christ. Verse 5, chapter 3, verse 5 is where I stop. Mortify, therefore, your members which are upon the earth, fornication, uncleanness, inordinate affection, evil conspicuousness, and covetousness, which is idolatry, for which things sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of disobedience, in the which ye also walked some time when you lived in them. But now ye also put off all these: anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth. Lie not to one another. People say that you can sin all you want, your future sins are forgiven, do whatever you want. We already talked to Judaizers. Let's talk to the greasy gracers. I think they stopped at that last part I read because they like it. When they talk about, hey, we're free, we have liberty. As Paul said, why are you trying to come in? Just like someone made a comment on the video I did of the children's Christmas program. Why are you teaching these children pagan traditions? Here the children are saying joy to the world. The Lord has come, and they're saying it's a pagan tradition. You know, that person, I removed their comment. What I should have said to them as I thought about it today, I should have asked them, why are you coming in trying to spire out the liberty we have in Christ? Go put on your yarmulke and prayer shawl and be a Jew and think you're a Jew when you're not, as the Bible says. Oh, here's the verse I mentioned to you before, verse 11. When after the image of him that created him, verse 11, where there is neither Greek nor Jew, circumcised nor uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, bond nor free, but Christ is all and in all. On that, in this topic of the video, lots of things I'm trying to cover. This is a new year, 2014, signs and wonders to follow those who follow the Lord Jesus Christ. That was my message. Signs and wonders to follow Joshua's ministry more publicly. And you too, if you're going to walk with the Lord, these signs shall follow you. In his name you'll cast out devils. In his name you'll lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. You will speak with new tongues. God bless you. The enemy can't hurt you with snakes, poison, and all that stuff. Mark chapter 16, at the end of the Gospel of Mark. God bless you guys. You know how I am. I like to jump around on topics as the Lord leads me. Just kind of flow with it. You know, I appreciate all those people that like to watch my videos. You know how I am. I just throw all these nuggets out there. And, you know, that's how I'm flowing with the Lord. I'm just flowing in the river of the Lord and just exercising, you know, surrendering and flowing with him and not sticking to my own text or agenda. I don't have notes. I've done that before. I can keep notes. Hey, I made an A in that class in school on how to do expository preaching. But I don't do that. I flow with the Spirit of God. That something that the Lord might want put out to his church might just come out in the flow of those things as the Lord would lead me. God bless you guys. Happy New Year. The year of our Lord 2014. This is a year of victory for the church. This is a year of victory for the true church. Those with oil in their lamps, this is a year of victory for the wise virgins. God's going to use every one of you in a mighty way. And I exhort you in the name of Jesus Christ. I exhort you. Be ready. Have your lamp trimmed, have your oil supply, all that you need to make it all the way in the procession march into the wedding chamber. And the Spirit and the bride say, come. Even so, Lord, come. Maranatha. Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be his honorous name. Blessed be his righteous name. Holy and worthy is he who is slain from the foundation of the world. And the Lord has confounded man with a lamb. God confounded mankind with the slaughter of a lamb, not an earthly lamb, brothers and sisters, but the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. Can you imagine that God spoiled powers and principalities and forces of darkness and kingdoms and rulers of this world in the darkness with the blood of a lamb? But our Lord Jesus Christ is worthy to kick off the tribulation by opening the seals, which I mentioned in a video the other day, and I got to make more videos on it. Worthy is the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. Blessing and honor and praise belong to Him. Give all your glory to the Lord. Stop trying to give glory and worship in this Old Testament stuff. Stop trying to worship Mama Mary. Stop trying to worship these saints. Stop trying to worship the golden calf of this world, of Wall Street, the bull of Wall Street. Stop worshiping money. You know, I have learned in the States, that one of the biggest lessons I learned in the States, I mentioned this before, it's very true what Jesus said. It's easier to fit a camel through the eye of a needle than a rich man to enter the kingdom of heaven. So it is true. Of course, everything the Lord says is true. It is definitely true. You cannot serve God and money. Blessed be the name of the Lord who causes us to triumph over all things in Christ Jesus.